Hello, and welcome to Encouragement Today. I am Marla Gordon, and I'm so glad you joined us. Yes, for real, this is only going to be 5 minutes. We're going to talk today about raise your hand because you know the answer. I taught a kindergarten class at our church many years ago, and those little five-year-olds were so adorable. At one Sunday, as I was teaching my lesson, I would read a little bit of the lesson of the story we were talking about and then stop and ask a question. And when I did ask the question, all the kids' hands raised in the air. They had a big old smile on their face, and they were so eager and wanted me to call on them to give the answer. So I called on this one little girl, and she said, "Jesus." And I said, "Well, yeah, that's right. We're talking about Jesus, but the answer to this particular question," and then I explained the answer. So then I read a little more of the story and asked another question. And again, all the kids' hands flew up in the air, big smiles on their faces, wanted me to call on them, so excited. So I called on this little boy, and he said, "Jesus." And I said, "Well, yeah, we're talking about Jesus, but the answer to this particular question is," and I explained it. So anyway, that went on over and over again through the whole story. As I read through the story and asked questions periodically, every single one of them raised their hands, smiles on their faces, and everyone I called on said Jesus. So I was getting a little frustrated because I wanted them to answer my specific question with a specific answer. Then I realized something. I realized they were answering my questions. I realized they were right. The answer to every question is Jesus. That was at least 25 years ago, and I remember it as if it was yesterday. It had a great impact on my life. Those five-year-olds taught me a lesson that day about Jesus. This scripture says, this is Matthew 18:3, and it says, "Verily I say unto you, except you be converted and become as little children, you shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven." And those kids remind me of that class that I had that day. The smiles on their faces, their hands waving in the air, so excited to answer. And every answer was Jesus. And that's the truth. Every question you have about your life, about things going on around you, the answer is Jesus. He is the answer. He has the answer. So every time you have a question, raise your hand in the air, put a smile on your face, and holler out Jesus every day, all day, wherever you're at your job, at a class at school, at church, shopping in the mall, shopping at the grocery store. Raise that hand when a question comes up. Out to eat, at the beach, at the movies, in your home, in your car. Jesus. He is the answer, and He has the answer. There's another scripture I wanted to share with you today, and it's Jeremiah 33:3. And it says, "Call on me, and I will answer you, and I will tell you great and mighty things which you do not know." If you notice a few words on there specifically, the beginning of it says, "Call on me." And then he says, "I will answer you. I will tell you." And isn't that what we always want? We have questions all the time. We want somebody to give us the answers. We want to find the answers. And there's the God's word that says, "Call on me and I will answer you. I will tell you great and mighty things that you do not know." There it is. Now the thing is, you need to say his name out loud, because this is a conversation. You want to be talking to him. He says, "Call me." So think about this. When you call someone on the phone and they say, "Hello," do you just sit there silently thinking about their name in your head? No, of course not. What we do, they say hello, we say, "Hi, Sue," "Hi, John," whoever it is you're calling. We say it out loud. And we need to talk to Jesus that way too. We need to raise our hands. And when we raise our hands, don't just think Jesus, say Jesus. He says, "Call on me." And so we say, "Jesus." So remember this. Raise your hands in the air. Be converted as little children. It's okay. Just do it. Let it go. And call on him, Jesus. He is the answer, and he has the answer. So in closing, remember this. Jesus Christ is the Son of God who took our sins to the cross. He died and shed his blood in our place. We deserve the punishment because the wages of sin is death. But Jesus took our sins to the grave and God raised him to life on the third day. Just open your heart and invite him in. It's really that easy. In a world where we can be anything, be kind. So thank you for joining us today. I love y'all, and we'll visit again real soon.